Welcome back, everyone, to Punny Plays the Champion. And today we are heading into the Midgewater Marshes. And I was wondering when that ancient creature will notice that I was trying to sneak behind it. And we need to kill a few Sneaker Breakers. And also some goblins. The main thing I'm after here are the goblins, since that will be the denser of the two enemies, but I'm hoping to at least get 8 Sneaker Breakers along the way so I can at least complete the Sneaker Breaker quest when I get there. Alright, the Sneakers are level 14, so they are a level ahead of me. Whack! And at this rate, I'm hoping to get to... Well, speaking of goblins, but I think I have to kill the goblins at the various... Oh, that's right, there are 2 goblin camps. So I have to keep that in mind. This might be one of them, though. Yeah, this is the sunken stone. So this is one of the 2 goblin camps. So let's take care of a couple of these. Yeah, they just love doing that, don't they? Actually, now I think about it, I'm still in red line, aren't I? Oops! So I should deal with that. As soon as I'm out of combat, at least. Okay, well, hit level 14. And... there we go, back to... yellow line. Now, let's see if we get to the other goblin camp, though we may have to run into a goblin or two from this camp along the way. I have my quest focus set to the chieftains. I think they're in the other goblin camp because, well, I figured they have to be at least in one of the 2 goblin camps. It'd be illogical for them to be, well, maybe. They like to keep themselves apart from their lesser brethren. Just die. That's the problem, is that you don't kill individuals as quickly when you're in yellow line, it looks like. I guess that's logical. Well, we'll probably eventually have a couple of red line traits in there when we get to high enough level to have multiples. Let's see, we've got 4. No, not. We put 5 of 8 right now, so we need only... well, 2 more after this one. The question is, can I kill this thing faster than it can burrow? Apparently so. It wasn't being very smart. And we're starting to run into more goblins here. Might mean that we're getting close to the goblin camp. And not quite close. Actually, I think... is that the camp there, or is that the major infestation of spiders? Which I think might be along the way. Actually, that looks too close to be the goblin camp. I think we are about to... get our last sneaker. Okay, there we go. Last sneaker! Come on, hello there! Yeah, try and run. What I need to do is to get myself a bow, I think. I don't think I've got one yet. I think I'm allowed to use them. Or do I have a bow? Actually, I don't have the let fire skill yet, so maybe I don't have bows yet. Maybe that's a later level. Well, we'll see about that. Next! Now that we have managed to get our quota of Sneaker Breakers. Oh! These are the Goblin Hole ruins. So, therefore, this is the next goblin area, and the chieftains are down in that area there, and I'm guaranteed to run into plenty of goblins to finish the goblin quest before I get to the chiefs. even if the chiefs don't count as goblins for this quest. I mean, it would be rather cheesy, I think, for them to count the chiefs for this. I mean, yes, you need to kill three goblins, and you kill the chiefs for the other two quests, and you say, okay, that's two of them, as if you can get to the chiefs without killing three of the goblins anyway. And right. Okay. As I just demonstrated there, I am already done with that quest. Now let's find those chiefs. Oh, level 9! Good grief! I mean, after those level 14 meekers, these... I mean, really? Level 9?! Why do you have me killing level 9 goblins for a level 14 quest? Like, even this, even Gerstum, this chief right here, is level 11. That is wrong. Wrong, 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 wrong. I mean, that's one of them. Now let's get to the other chief. I mean, they're black wolves that are higher level than that. Alright, let's see. Well, let's take care of this. Yeah, here. Actually, now that we've got... Yeah. Ooh, right, and... Oh. Oops. Okay, there is the final chief there. Now, it'd be nice if I had some... food. That's the problem. I decided not to do crafting would be another thing I wouldn't do in this challenge character. And that may be a bit of a problem. Because that makes things easier. Alright, there we go. Okay, good. That's level. So I'm level 14 and I finished 3 quests. And now I just have to turn these in. Which is over here. But I think these goblins were just too easy, in my opinion. And we got a ranger. Hello there. But actually, Bill Mossfoot. Maybe that's not a ranger. He's dressed like a ranger. Okay, let's see what he says. Is it saying anything that makes it sound like... Because this guy dressed like a ranger, but he has a very Breelandish name. Let's see what he says here. It is as I feared, Pinecut. If the goblins have already spread so far throughout the Midgewater marshes, they intend to stay. If it were not for the spider infestation in the ruins of the northern stretch of the marshes, I would expect the goblins to seize those as well. Right. And increasing. So now I need to kill some sappers. Frankly, I'm not really all that fond of wanting to do that quest. I'll take it for now, but I might just decide not to finish it. Simply because all these level 9 goblins are just... really. And well done, these two are dealt... I know, I almost got killed. Yes, I said yeah. Alright, let's see. So, turn that in. He just wants me to kill flies, actually.
Would you do
maybe I will
me?
Kill a fly or two.
Greetings.
And she had me kill the sneakers.
Would you do something for
me? And now to kill the spiders. And I think the spiders would be the more interesting quest. So that's the one that I'll actually be heading for. Oh, yes, I don't want to do that. I want to do... actually, there are probably spiders everywhere. We have that fort... up there. Actually, I think that's the fort where I really like to go after the spiders, especially since that's where we'll find the Marsh Queen. But if I do run into a sapper, ignore them. Now, this is a greater sticklefly. Okay. I mean, if I run into one of the other quest items along the way, no problem. Now, I really should have some... Do I have anything to eat since... Yeah. I'll just have the... there you go. The devil mends crabs in order to at least give me something to eat. And I better take care of that. Hopefully that'll at least give me something in there, even if crab is not the best food you can get. There are a lot of other better things to get. What is this? This is bracing attack. Plus 150. Oh! Let's see, costs 3 fervor. Oh, okay, I better put that with my fervor stuff, and it does increase your morale. So actually, that's a heal. So I should put that up here where it belongs and be ready to use that to do a little self-heal if necessary. I could ignore those goblins and head into the ones to here where I think I'll find my spiders. And spiders, I think, would be the more challenging quest and to test my skills as a champion. Because here we got level 14 enemies. And I expect there to be at least one occasion where I'll be going against two or three at a time. Oh, fun! And it's a good thing that I found bracing attack just in time, just in case I do run into several at a time. Because the big one is the queen, because whenever I have something called Spider Queen, you know that there are other spiders that say, "Hello, you're hurting our queen. Don't do that." And they all then come in and attack you. Okay, I don't need bracing attack there. Yeah, we have plus 154 morale. That's the way things go. It's good that they put the ones that have heals in them so that you could recognize it even if you forget the specific name. You can just look at the icon there. Alright, there we go. And we'll just add the ancient altar to our list of items that we have found. See how am I doing? I've got marsh spiders. See, this is my final marsh spider I need. I need brood watchers. Marsh brood watchers are the ones I need more. Oh, we got some of these are level 15. Yeah, this is definitely going to be a challenge to my skills. Right. Okay, and because marsh spiders, yeah, it's easy to get those. I think the brood queen is to be careful on, if I remember this properly. Especially since she's a signature. Level 50. Well, it looks like that if you are careful, you can get her alone. Alright. I guess I'm confusing her with the queens that you find in Scary, which are, well, scary. I guess that's a good word for the queens down there. Let's see. And good. Took care of the marsh queen, took care of that. Just need to find a few more brood watchers, and I am set. Was a bit easy. And how am I doing in my level? Yeah, I'm getting pretty close to 15 here. It looks like I am going to hit 15 before the end of this episode. Which means that next episode, I will be doing the champion class quest. Which I think brings me back all over the place. Alright, let's see. More brood watchers. Let's go! And I still have a couple more goblins to kill. Let's yes. I don't need any more of these. Maybe a couple of flies if I decide to finish off that quest, but I don't need any more sneakers. So, where can I find a brood watchers? Hopefully there are some mothers in the area. It's always a pain whenever the rare one is the one they need more of. I mean, why do they do this to you? I don't know. You have all these marsh spiders all over the place. Sickle fly. And of course, the greater sickle flies are the ones that you need for that quest. And let's see, as for those sappers, I'm probably not going to finish that one. Good, and... ah, my final brood watcher. And in case you want to know why I'm not doing crafting, one, of course, is that the challenge on the matter. But the other one is, of course, is... it tends to give you XP. And I certainly don't want to be getting XP through ways that are too easy. So unless I did something like get a tortoise stone or something like that, which I guess could be a possibility. Ah, here's a greater sickle fly, so I can at least get some wings. And maybe I could actually... I've only got one so far, but I don't think the drop rate on the wings is all that good. Actually, what happens if I switch back to red for this? Alright. And do it that way, seeing that, yeah, you go a lot faster against a single opponent when you do that. So probably learning to jump back and forth between stances would be one of the things I could learn in doing this, so that I can take advantage of the best of both of these. So if I expect to go against singles, then red line works out pretty well. If I am going against individuals, then I mean against singles, yeah. Red. Oops. Oh, there's level 15. Alright. And I've got the sickle fly wings all done. So I think it is time to... well, I have to go... yeah. But it's... oh, well, the goblins are weak anyway, so therefore... suboptimal battle against them, I presume, isn't going to be a major problem to me. But it looks like I'm not going to be able to get those 8 goblins. So I will turn this in, and when I come back next time, we are going to go and try the champion class quest in the next episode of Piney Plays the Champion.